up, YouTube? It's your girl Jada, and I am back with another freaking video. And as you see by the title, I'm going to be doing a story time on my very first fight. This video has been requested for the freaking longest, since almost my first video, and I'm just getting around to doing it or whatever, because I did Insta questions the other day, and I got like 12 questions that said, can you post a story time, can you post a story time, can you post a story time. And my life is kind of boring, so really don't nothing be happening, so I just was like, well, I might as well do, you know, my first fight or whatever. Just a disclaimer, by no means do I promote fighting at all. It is never the solution to anything. I'm a firm believer in bump them haters, go about your business, because they're not paying your mama bills, period, or your bills if you got any or whatever. But sometimes, you know, stuff happen and you be caught in a situation and, you know, you just gotta fight it out. Sometimes stuff happens, you know, you get angry in the midst of the situation, especially when you're young, and you just be like, screw it, let's hit. You know, both of these fights are old. I'm going to be talking about two of them because they're short stories pretty much. One happened in seventh grade and one happened in ninth grade. So, of course, I was young. I'm in 12th grade now. I'm wiser, older, and they were both with friends. They were small disagreements. I love both of these females to death. We're still cool to this day. And, you know, it was just minor disagreements or whatever. But if you want to hear about my first two fights, then keep watching. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And also turn on the bell for post notifications so you could be one of my gems. And if you're returning, welcome back, my gem. But that's enough talking for the moment. Let's get into the stories. So the first fight that I got into was in eighth grade. It's one of my friends. We're still friends to this day. Like, you might as well say we family, and we were still friends after the fight or whatever. But okay, we used to do this thing in middle school. We gonna call her by her name. Do y'all even call her by name? Y'all might have seen her on my snap. I'm always with her. It's a light skin girl. Y'all always claim that we look alike. We look nothing alike, but y'all always say we look alike. I guess it's cause I call her sis. Y'all think we look alike, but we don't look alike at all. But anyways, we just gonna call her, we gonna call her Kaya, because her name Kaya. So anyways, back to the story. I wish she was here so I could tell it with her. But yeah, so we used to do this thing in middle school where we would like call our friends wifey or whatever. So she was my wifey, but we had other friends, and another girl, I would call her my wifey, like on a down low. But Kaya was the main wifey, but she was my low-key wifey or whatever. So, and we just play like, oh my God, you cheating on me, you cheating on me, or whatever. Childish, right? And so one day in PE or whatever, we were having a big old dispute between, we would have one group called Fat Boys Entertainment, and then another one, I forgot what the other one was called, but basically it was a big old, you know, discombobulated situation or whatever. It was a big old situation. Everybody's yelling outside at gym and all that. And so I basically was like, Kaya, I'm cheating on you. Like, you know, that's why I'm cheating on you now, because we was on two different sides of the spectrum. I think she was with PBE and I wasn't. And so, yeah. So we just was like going back and forth. But we were playing. This all playing, whatever, whatever. So we goes back, we outside, like, at the little bootleg track. Like, I know some middle schools, you know, some middle schools don't have, like, the football field and the track and all that. Our middle school didn't have one, so they used to put cones in the parking lot, and we would have to, run around and walk around them or whatever. So we left the track or whatever and went inside the gym or whatever. Whole time we talking trash. So the other group, they decide to go on the other side of the freaking gym or whatever. And so, like, my group where I was with, we went on one side of the gym. So I got my best friend, Jakaya, and I'm like, go tell Kaya I'm talking shit. And I'm messy. Like, I was so petty for that, because I should have knew she was going to come over there. Because one thing about it, about Kaya, she not going to back down from nobody, right? And so I'm like, I started the pot. Like, I really, to be honest, I started it. And I just wanted some mess to pop off or whatever. I was messy. But it was all fun and games. We was just playing. So I didn't think nothing of it. It was no type of drama involved at all. So I went and she went and told her. She ran over there and told her. And then all I seen was Kaya coming over there. And she gonna take me and slam me against the wall. And I'm like, did she just slam me against the wall? So I hit her in the face. And all I know is we started fighting, y'all. We just started fighting, like fighting. So this one girl, we gonna call her, the girl who tried to break up the fight was the wifey that I was cheating with. We gonna call her, what we gonna call her? We gonna call her Katie. We gonna call her Katie. So yeah, Katie, which is the wife that I'm cheating with, the whole part of the beef, you know, that started, she decides to come and break it up. So she's like, got her legs. I'm gonna show y'all. I'm on this side, Kaya on this side. Katie is in between us like this, but she's facing Kaya. She's facing Kaya. Mind y'all, Kaya is tall as fuck. Kaya is like, we in seventh grade now. Kaya a clean ass. What? She's tall now. She's about 5'6". Not 5'6". She's about 5'7", 5'8". I don't know. Maybe I'm over exaggerating. But I'm small, so anybody to me gonna be big. So you see how long my arms are? Not that long at all. So Kaya throwing hits. I'm throwing hits too. But instead of throwing hits to Kaya, I'm hitting Shawty in the middle. And I feel bad because I'm like, you know, they ain't going nowhere. Them hits ain't hitting. So they not connecting with the person they're supposed to connect to. So Kaya hitting me. And this is like the person in the middle is just getting butchered the whole time. So that's when the coaches, you know, blew the whistle or whatever. And so they finally broke it up. But they didn't know who was fighting because it was this big old commotion. So we all walked off and she walked out the gym and all that. And I was like, oh my God, I was like trying to figure out, oh my God, but we still, you know, it wasn't that serious or whatever. So that's when the principal came and I guess they figured out who it was. And so they all made us go to the office or whatever. So whole time we walking up to the principal's office, we and her talking, we like, hey, we want for real, you know, we still tight, you know, because it wasn't like that at all. Like, it wasn't no beef situation. And so, we get to the principal's office or whatever, and the principal is like, so what happened? We all smiling, we talking, we like, no, we was just arguing, and everybody crowded around and thought we was fighting. Whole time, we physically fought. So, yeah, we just, you know, she let us off with a warning or whatever, and we walked down the hallway holding hands. Like, everybody was leaving gym, and we walked down the hallway holding hands. And they looking like, what the fuck? And the PE coach was just like, didn't they just? And we like, got them, period. We still tight, period. So, yeah, that was one of my fights. And so, I don't really count that as one of my fights because whole time we were still tight. Wasn't no drama involved, you know. We basically just fought, but it was mainly really a play fight. It wasn't really a serious fight. So, yeah, and that's still my girl to this day, you know, whatever. We still 3-2 cool, period. Family and still tight. And, you know, it wasn't a fight about, like, it wasn't a disloyalty fight or, like, a argumentative type fight. It was just we was playing too much and it went too far, you know what I'm saying? But that's not my only fight. Now, this fight that happened, I claim this is a real fight because I was mad. I wasn't mad that last fight, but this fight, I was mad. So, we just gonna call this girl, and disclaimer again, this girl is still my friend. I love her to death. She know that I would do anything for her, period, you know. It's just, you know, at that point in time, you know, we was, like, at a bad place. So, this is really what y'all want to hear. So, we gonna call her, because I don't want to say her name. We gonna call her Tiana. And if she watches video, she gonna be like, girl, what? Like, really? Obvious, you know? But we gonna call her Tiana. So, me and Tiana been cool since, goddamn, 7th grade or whatever. You know, she would come to my house. You know, we was 3-2 cool. We was best friends for a good minute. So, throughout me and Tiana's whole friendship, she always been a bossy friend. You know what I'm saying? You know, we all got no friends who just like my way or the highway, period. You know what I'm saying? And I'm the same way. So we always like clash heads. Like all the time. It never failed. We will always be arguing about something because it's like, if it's not her way, it's the highway. And if it's not my way, it's the highway. And so I understood like Tiana's situation. And you know, I understood like, you know, everything that, you know, she had going on or whatever. So that's why I kind of felt like closer to her and special. Like, I feel like she's my special friend just because, you know, our relationship was different than all my other friends. You know what I'm saying? And there's a lot of adversity surrounding her when it came to my other friends. I just felt like no matter what, like, I would always, you know, no matter what had happened, you know, drama, etc., I would always have her back. But yeah, so she used to, okay, she was out of zone or whatever. So she would come to my house in the mornings to ride the bus. So, you know, she could go to our school still. You know, we went to the same school. And so, you know, like every day, every morning, you know, it would be an everyday thing. She would just come over and we'll go to the bus, you know, whatever, whatever. I know a lot of y'all probably heard these type of situations. So one morning, we were talking about a situation. I told her how I was talking to this boy. And she basically was like, you're dumb, he a hoe, blah, 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 blah. But I didn't think nothing of it. I just was like, whatever. And so I said, that's why I don't tell you anything. That's why I tell my other friend. So she kind of felt some type of way about it. And she was like, you always, you know, putting my other, your other friends before me and blah, blah, blah. I don't care if you do that or whatever. And so basically, and y'all, this situation is so petty. So basically, I was like, well, you can come to my house and ride the bus with me in the mornings, but don't sit by me on the bus, because we got in a big old heated argument. We was going back and forth, and she was like, I'm gonna sit where I want to sit. And I'm like, just don't sit by me, okay? So we arguing the whole time at the bus stop. This whole morning we arguing, like, I already, you know, and she's always been so aggressive, like so aggressive. But it's like she's the type of aggressor that later on feels so bad about being aggressive, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, it's hard to explain. But you know how some people, like, get so angry and then later they feel bad about it or whatever? That's how she was or whatever. And so, yeah. And so that whole morning at the bus stop, we arguing. So she finally, like, we get the bus finally comes or whatever. We are, the whole morning we are arguing at the bus stop or whatever. Left my house arguing, bus stop arguing, all that. So we finally get on the bus and, mind you, I told her, don't sit by me on the bus. You can come to my house in the morning and catch the bus with me. Just don't sit by me on the bus. Don't talk to me, okay? So she proceeds, and knowing me, I did not mean any harm by it. I just was saying that because I was mad at the moment. You feel me? Like, next day, we always would argue one day and then be back besties the next. So I didn't think nothing of it. I was just being petty for the moment. So the bus comes. I get in the seat, and I put my book bag, like, in between us, like in between us. This girl takes my book bag and sits it in my lap and sits beside me. And I'm like, what do you want? Girl, move. Like, if I'm telling you you can catch the bus with me, just don't sit by me, then do that. So she still sits by me anyway. So I decide to get my book bag, and I, like, because at first the book bag was just on the edge of the seat, so she wouldn't sit by me, but she moved it as soon as we got on the bus. So I decide to scoot over closer to the window, and I put the book bag in between us. So she keep, like, throwing my book bag. Like, it was so petty, y'all. It's so funny. She kept taking my book bag, just throwing it over the seat, over the seat. And I know everybody on the bus is like, what do you got going on? And so I'm like, can you please stop, Tiana? Like, leave me alone. I'm not doing that to you. You harassing me at this point. Leave me the fuck alone. So she's like, no, because she don't tell me what to do. And she real argumentative. So I just was like, man, oh my God. So, you know, I'm popping my shit. I'm on the window. I'm talking, whatever. I'm like, we going back and forth, whatever. So she stands up and she like, what's up? This girl said, what's up? So I'm like, what's up mean fighting words. Mind you, I'm not a fighter type. I'm not an aggressor in any type of way. I'm a lover, not a fighter. So I just was like, really, dog? You gonna try and pump me in front of all these people? You supposed to be my dog. Like, she really stood up and said, what's up? Like, she, mind you, we on the bus. So she's standing over me. I'm sitting down. She said, what's up? So I'm like, in my head, I'm like, do I really want to do this? Because that's fighting words. And I know that means she want to fight. So, you know, I was pondering between letting her have it and, you know, popping it off. But it just was like, it comes a certain point where, like, we used to argue so much and it used to be so many altercations. Like, it come a point where you still gotta fight somebody like they're your siblings. It, all siblings fight. I don't care what nobody say. Me and my siblings fight all the time, but I wouldn't let nobody bother them. But I mean, it was that. It was like that. We would argue like we sisters, like we live together or whatever. So I feel like come a certain point where you just gotta get, you know, you just gotta, you know, like, what's up? So she still even said what's up. So I thought that's what she wanted. You know, I thought she wanted to fight. You know, I had nothing in my head. And also at the same point, I wasn't finna let nobody pump me. Because at that point, we was kind of arguing loudly. But it was still like, you know, oh, they ain't gonna fight. And everybody like, we do that all the time. You know, they always arguing. So, like, literally, we always argue. Everybody on the bus was like, y'all always arguing. So it's nothing new. So after she stood up and said, what's up? After I pondered, I decided to stand up. And I hit her. I hit the girl, y'all. I hit her. So, you hit somebody, you gonna get hit back, right? So, she hit me. So, we just fighting on the bus. I'm telling y'all, we was fighting for a long ass time. Like, we stopped at like 3 or 4 stops before we finally stopped fighting. And then we fought again. We fought 2 or 3 times on the same bus, y'all. Same route. So, I hit her. I'm not gonna lie, I did hit her first. But what followed, we just was fighting. Like, we just was fighting. Mind y'all, in 9th grade, all I wore was freaking box braids. Sis pulled out all my freaking edges. All of my freaking edges, for real. Like, I was so fucking hurt. Like, I wasn't even just hurt from my edges. I was just hurt because I felt like it should have never reached that point between us. You know what I'm saying? Because I felt like we was like this. And we were always able to go around the situation. Like, whenever we argue, we were always, you know, talk it out. But I feel like that they were resorted to that. I kind of felt, you know, hurt or whatever. Because I'm sensitive. And I feel like anybody that I keep close to me, friendship-wise, actually worth something. You know what I'm saying? Like, I actually value them. I'll do anything for my friends, my people that I call, you know, my people. So, I kind of felt hurt by that or whatever. But anyways, we fighting on the bus. Whole time we fighting on the bus. So, this boy, we gonna call him his name. We gonna call him Jerry. He tried to break up the damn fight. So he got Tiana up against the seat and he fucked up when he did this because all I had was her face. Like, I had her face. Like, he had her pinned up against the seat. So I'm just hitting. Hitting. And I'm not going to say I won the fight. I'm not going to say she won the fight. I mean, to be honest, nobody did because we fought like 2 or 3 times. Like I said, it was never no like constant. It wasn't no constant fight and then we done. Okay. But then after Jerry let her go, I forgot what happened. After Jerry let her go, I kind of went to the back a little bit. And I don't know why I was crouched over with her, but she came back and kicked me in my fucking face. And I had like a little thing right here for the longest. And my mom was like, did you win or did you lose? Because you kind of like you got a black eye. But sis had fucking kicked me. Matter of fact, I don't even remember. People were saying that she kicked me. People said she was like, she punched me. But I don't remember because I kind of like black out in situations like those. I think it was a kick because she had to get me good for me to bruise right there. So I think she kicked me or whatever. And because I remember I was bending down looking for something. I think I lost my earring. I lost something. But yeah, basically we fought or whatever. And then after the fight, she just yelling, doing a yelling match. I'm like, oh my God, after everything I've done for you and blah, blah, blah. And we just going back and forth, yelling on the bus. I didn't call my mama. Oh, me and Tiana just fall. You got me at the school. Come pick me up, blah, 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 and all that. So nobody really knew about this fight, but they knew, you know what I'm saying? Because what followed after, me and her was beefing for about 2 or 3 months after the fact. So, yeah, so she just, I don't know. So, after we fought, the bus driver claimed that I was talking back, being nasty. But, I mean, I was mad at that point, and it had just escalated something that I wasn't expecting that early in the damn morning. You know what I'm saying? It's 6 a.m. Who the hell trying to be fighting? You know what I'm saying? I be trying to catch my Z's on the bus. I be trying to catch my fucking Z's on the bus. And you want to fight early this damn morning. Yeah, where did all that energy come from is what I want to know. Like, girl, if you don't take a nap. But the whole situation was petty or whatever. So we finally got to the school. And I guess that, you know, they got the little radios that they talk on or whatever. And so I guess the school already knew that there was a fight. So that's when the principal was waiting on us when we got to the school. And so he's like, all right, y'all come with me or whatever. Still, nobody knew we had fought. We fought on the bus. We didn't fight at school, so it wasn't really a big thing or whatever. So that's when, you know, we go to the office. Guess how many days we got suspended for a bus fight? We didn't get suspended off the bus. We got suspended from school. And try and guess how many days. 5 freaking days. 5 days may not seem like a lot now, but then I was freaking angry because it's like it was a weekend and then after that it followed or whatever. And so, yeah, we just was, you know, that whole time, like, it was a lot of, like, Facebook beef or whatever. And, like, she would say little smart stuff. And, like, every post I made, she would think it was about me. And every post she made, I would think was about me. And we just would go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And so, we always had a weird-ass friendship in general. And so, like, she would send me little stuff and she'd be like, I know we not cool, but look at this bitch. Or, you know, and vice versa. So, I mean, I always knew, like, okay, we fought, but I feel like we were older. We were big, like, I feel like our friendship was strong enough to not let that get, you know, take a toll on us. And even though we beefed for a long time after that and we weren't cool, we didn't talk, you know, and it was, like, little stuff said and all that. Eventually, we just, you know, talked it out and we just was back cool. Because I feel like when you and somebody actually, you know, really have a real relationship, and y'all actually care about each other, y'all are able to get over, you know, anything. And I feel like we really needed that break because we were just, I don't know, we really needed that break. And I feel like that break made us realize that we really value each other's friendship or whatever. And yeah, so after that, we got back cool or whatever. And still to this day, we like laugh about that. Like, we really fought, bruh. We really freaking fought. You know what I'm saying? And of course, the friendship was a little different after that. But at the end of the day, you know, I still have love and respect for her. And yeah, I just, you know. But that was my first fight. Like I said, my fights weren't really anything excited, spectacular, like how some people's may be. But y'all wanted to know about them. But yeah, basically I got 5 days. I told my mama about it. Come to find out, her mom to this day still doesn't know that we fought. And I feel like that's the craziest thing ever. Because I told my mom, and y'all know moms sometimes, you know, feel some type of way about stuff like that. But the fact that she didn't tell her mom, I kind of felt like, dang, we really fought. And you still, like, she kind of knew, like, we still gonna be cool after this. Like, we're not gonna let this break us. And I told my mom, just because I tell my mom everything. But her mom still don't know to this day. And I just was like, what? But yeah, that's pretty much the story. Like I said, nothing too exciting, but you guys have requested this video for the longest, and I just decided I might as well film and record it. But yeah, just to close out this video, I want to let you guys know that I just want to close this video out and say, by no means is fighting ever the necessary solution to any type of situation. It is not a good resolution, and fighting, it will never get you anywhere but suspended, hurt, or somewhere else in jail. Because I'm 17 now, I'm not fighting nobody. I'm finna turn 18 years old. You want to fight me, girl, you better fight the wall, because you ain't fighting me, baby. You better fight the air, fight something else. You better fight them feelings that you got towards me, because sis, I ain't fighting nobody. I'm too cute to be fighting anybody. And you know, I got nails, baby, and my nails ain't cheap. So I ain't feeling it. I ain't going for it, period. I'm not a fighter. I love people. Anybody who has an issue with me, that's on them. But yeah, just, I feel like fighting, never resort to fighting unless you have to. If somebody hits you, that's something. But if somebody just talking, popping with you, it's never, you know, that's never the answer. So that's just how I feel about it. It's a lot of people in this world that's not going to like you. It's a lot of people who going to argue with you, pick fights with you. But guess what? You got to be the bigger person and realize that you got more stuff going for yourself and you got too much going on to, you know, be fighting somebody's child. You know what I'm saying? So that's all it is. I love you guys. We're almost to 100 freaking K. I think we're at 91K now. We popping, we lit, and it's on like Donkey Kong when I hit 100K, period. But if you like what you've seen, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next freaking video.